Thank you for joining us. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. Hello, basketball fans. Brian Anderson here, courtside with Doris Burke and Grant Hill. Our reporter is Allie LaForce. A moment here to see the numbers for Kristaps Porzingis.
Effective field goal percentage is a great way to measure his performance over the previous 10 games. It's been much improved, a sign that his game has been evolving.
Just about ready to get this one started. First, let's hear from Allie LaForce. Allie.
Rudy Gobert has had his skeptics. He said, quote, "No one ever thought I could be an NBA player or one of the leaders on my team. It's the story of my life and something that I embrace. The better you get, the more people talk. So I take every criticism as a compliment. Either way, you cannot let it affect you." Brian?
Good stuff, Allie. Thanks. Well, we're at the time of the calendar when some teams go through a midseason lull. Grant, what has to be done to avoid that?
Well, first of all, you have to keep your composure. You cannot panic. And of course, this is when a coach earns his keep. Motivation becomes key. Keeping the players focused and making sure nobody starts coasting.
And now the Washington Wizards starters. In the middle, it's Porzingis with Kuzma by his side. Morris and Beal are the backcourt pair. And it's Kispert in at small forward. And for Minnesota, filling in the wings, Edwards and McDaniels. Kyle Anderson is out there with Rudy Gobert. And it's Conley in at the one. Now here's Edwards. Turned in an outstanding game against Dallas. Gobert with a screen on Beal. Here's Edwards. McDaniels finds Edwards. Six on the shot clock. The shot by Conley. No good. Edwards against Beal. To the inside. It's deflected. And here's Conley. Gobert with a screen on Kuzma. Conley. It's hauled in by Beal. Well, you know the Timberwolves are a young squad, Doris. When will it be their time, you think?
I think, B.A., when you have a talent that is the anchor of your organization, which they have in Karl Anthony Towns, Cat is one of the most talented big men, most polished offensive players that we've seen in the NBA. Couple him with Anthony Edwards and Rudy Gobert, and I think you now have to start looking to be a consistent winner. I am anxious to see what this team does this year.
Now here's Edwards, a top-tier scorer, averaging a little under 25 points a contest. It's McDaniels on the wing. Gobert passes to McDaniels. The kick out to Conley. Edwards with it. 4-3. The Timberwolves again can't hit. Here's Morris. Right now contributing around 10.5 points a game. Kuzma outside. And that comes off the assist by Morris.
That is Kyle Kuzma asserting himself against quality defense. Nice finish.
Conley against Morris. Conley passes to Edwards. Outside McDaniels. Pass to Gobert. Right side Edwards. Gobert no good.
Well, conversions have been a problem. 0-for-4.
Here's Beal. It's blocked by Gobert.
Defensively, few players have had a bigger impact than Rudy Gobert. That combination of energy and length and commitment, so good defensively.
And that's how you defend. He wasn't showing any mercy with that swat.
And that kind of rejection early on energizes your squad. The coaching staff just loves this kind of hustle.
Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Anderson against Kuzma.
Yet another miss. Just 1-for-5. Not exactly an ideal start.
Edwards finds Anderson. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws. Kristaps Porzingis picks one up.
Man, good whistle there.
How about this, Doris? The Wizards haven't been to the conference finals since 1979. Unreal.
That's exactly right, B.A., and it gives you some sense of how tough it is to be successful in the NBA, because it's not that long ago that their backcourt consisted of John Wall and Bradley Beal. Many at the time considered it one of the most dangerous in the league and thought they would be here for over a decade. It does show you how hard sustained success is in the NBA.
He hits the second from the line.
You know, the Wizards really came up short last season on the defensive end. They consistently struggled to get stops, which makes it twice as hard to win games.
Now here's Morris. Porzingis for three. And Conley grabs the miss. The Timberwolves trail. Pass to Edwards. Picked by Gobert. It's Edwards with a drive, and Edwards slams it in.
Boy, the quickness off the dribble drive by Anthony Edwards. Being able to put it on the deck, so important.
The Wizards have gone only 1 of 6 so far. I just wonder how the Wizards can remedy their defensive weaknesses from last year.
Well, B.A., mindset is a big part of it. They just need to have better focus on pressuring the ball handlers and making sure shots are getting well contested. He's consistent from out there, especially when you give him that kind of room.
And we're just over 3.5 minutes into this first quarter. Gobert with a screen on Morris. Edwards for three. Rebounded by Kuzma. Washington has gone 1 of 2 from three-point land so far. Pass to Beal. Porzingis with a screen on Edwards. Here's Beal. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
And look at this. This summer, a 5-year extension for Bradley Beal. One of the richest contracts in NBA history. Over $240 million.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Free throw drops for Beal. And he's certainly elite. But does it surprise you that Bradley Beal has one of the biggest contracts in the NBA, Grant?
And that's just how it works. I mean, give it a few years and all the stars will be paid the same. That said, it must be nice. Those are some big checks.
The Wizards making a switch here. Gafford, he's checked in for Kristaps Porzingis. Avdija comes in for Kuzma. Nunn's checked in for Kispert. And Wright subbed in for Morris.
You want to contest this guy's shot, but you absolutely don't want to send him to the line. He will make you pay.
Pass to Noel. Here's Rivers. Right now averaging 5.5 a game. Picked by Prince. 5 to shoot. Beal with some nice D.
Never easy to stop this guy at the rim, but that is a beautiful contest right there.
A minute 29 left in the first. And again, Washington, no good.
I'm sure he's kicking himself. He hates to blow that kind of opportunity.
Pass to Prince. Reed sets a screen. Knocked loose. Beal against Reed. Goes back up. Good.
What a high percentage look for DeLon Wright. What an opportunity, and he finishes.
Minnesota has gone 0 for 3 from downtown. Outside, Anderson. Pass to Reed. Will it go? Avdija pulls it in.
And he almost made them regret defending him so loosely.
Here's Gafford. It's Wright on the wing. Back to Gafford. Three-pointer, Beal. And again, Washington with a triple.
Down in the corner, Beal shoots with confidence. Just one more area he can score from consistently.
26 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Outside, Anderson. Anderson. Down low. Up top, Beal. Beal with another miss. And so it's Washington with a 9-point cushion at the end of the quarter. And their defense has stood out, wreaking havoc for the opposition. And more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way right after this. If you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And what do you think about how the Wizards are doing here?
It's simple. The main takeaway from the first quarter is they're winning this game with defense.
I think across the board, a number of guys who've done a great job guarding multiple positions.
Here's Wright. They lead by the biggest margin of the game at 9. All right, this is how the floor looks for the Wizards starting in the second. Avdija and Kuzma, they make up the forwards. Kendrick Nunn out there with DeLon Wright. And it's Porzingis in at the 5. And Doris, last season, only 5 NBA players participated in all 82 games. That's a record low in the league's history.
Well, in addition to that, Brian, consider the previous low was 17. So that's not even close. Now, we know the health and safety protocols contributed to that number, but it is pretty clear we're in the age of load management. What impact is that having on the league in terms of fan base?
And he drops a first.
What I like about the Minnesota Timberwolves, to me, they took a step forward last season. Finishing their highest conference finish since 2004, made it all the way up to the 7th spot in a very competitive West.
Both shots good from the stripe. And looking at the progress Minnesota has made, many think the best is yet to come, Doris.
Well, they've made smart draft acquisitions, beginning with young Mr. Anthony Edwards, a big-time talent. And obviously, you've got to grow that young talent. That's exactly how you build a bright future for your team.
And down it goes. 2 points. Edwards has got his second basket of the game.
Man, that strength and concentration from Anthony Edwards. Yes, there's contact. Doesn't bother him.
Pass to Porzingis. Now here's Wright. From downtown, buries it from 3. Wright's got 7 points.
Listen, this guy is not the most dangerous threat from there, but you have got to honor the shooting a little bit.
Up top, Edwards. Nunn defends. McDaniels from long range. He's off on that one. And Washington the other way now. Kuzma outside. Pass to Wright. Now Porzingis. And here is Kuzma. Misses the 3. We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now. They're searching for a way to score.
Yeah, buckets have been very tough to come by.
So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
Well, a big trade over the summer, bringing Rudy Gobert to the Wolves. And it's a bit of a fresh start for Gobert, a main star of this team that is loaded with talent, but needed that defensive anchor.
First one falls.
Even on the years he's not winning Defensive Player of the Year, Rudy Gobert finds a way to finish in the top 3. This is one of the most consistent elite defenders in the game.
Kispert's checked in for Washington. Morris comes in for Wright. And so Gobert nails both of them. And Doris, with Gobert, it still feels like he doesn't get the credit he deserves.
And B.A., at this point, I find that inexcusable. You just watch the game and understand the metrics. to see the massive impact that Rudy Gobert has on winning. It is not only on the defensive end either.
Kuzma outside. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up. It's going to be on Naz Reid.
You have to be aware, if you're a defender, where Kyle Kuzma is. This guy is a scorer by nature.
All right, guys, what do you think so far about the offensive approach for the Wizards?
Take a break.
In the era of the three-point basket. So if you want to win games in this league, you have to connect from deep, and they have been thus far.
And the other thing I love, how they're making the extra pass. They're not settling for the first shot. They're going from good to great.
Well, the 27th pick in 2017, Kyle Kuzma made first-team all-rookie. He was displaying just sort of significantly better shooting in the pros than he did in college at Utah.
Hits one, then misses the second attempt from the line. Boy, you look at Kuzma's shooting percentages. His rookie season, still his most efficient, Grant.
Yeah, B.A. I mean, he stayed at about that same level. But as an offensive-minded player, if he can progress a little, that would certainly help his value.
And that was the Mobile One drive. Low resistance to the finish line.
Yeah, they're trying to close this gap. Always a good option to probe the paint and see if you can get an easy one inside.
Here's Kuzma. The Timberwolves getting their last shot to go. Basket counts.
Now he's got a lean frame, but Kyle Kuzma proving he's unafraid of a little bit of contact inside.
And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. Pass to Conley. Here's McDaniels. Takes a three. And they recover it. Tries again. Out of bounds. It'll be Wizards ball. And a chance to look at the block shot numbers over the last few seasons for Rudy Gobert.
And his shot blocking hasn't been nearly as potent as it was a few years ago. It's a shame, really, because his ability to intimidate the other team and be a big presence on the defensive end really gave his team an edge.
Morris against Conley. Oh, rejected by McDaniels. Outside Conley. The kick out to Edwards for three, and the three-pointer goes. Edwards got 5 points in the quarter.
There's a reason Mike Conley's teammates love playing with him. If you're open, I promise he'll find you.
Washington has gone 3 of 5 from the perimeter in this game. A chance here to catch up with Allie from the sideline.
Thanks, B.A. Bradley Beal played for Coach Greg Popovich with the U.S. national team, and Pop said, quote, he's hard to keep up with. His balance and movement are very impressive. He stops on a dime, can pull up and shoot. That, along with his excellent footwork, are the most impressive things for me. Brian?
Yeah, great breakdown there, Allie. Thank you. Now here's Conley. Coming off a 12-point game. Reed for three. Tips it. It's good on the putback.
Well, putting all of that 7-foot frame to use, Rudy Gobert has been one of the consistent offensive rebounders in the league.
Pass to Kispert. Morris, a screen on Edwards. Right side, Porzingis. Up and over Conley. And another miss by Washington. Minnesota has gone 1 of 4 from 3-point land here in the second. A minute 53 left to play in the first half. And Gobert with the stuff.
Wow, why lay it in when you can send an emphatic message? Rudy Gobert on the dunk.
The Wizards with a lead. Morris outside. Pass to Kuzma. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two. Well, the Timberwolves struck gold by getting the number one pick in the 2015 and 2020 NBA drafts.
You are so right, B.A., selecting Karl-Anthony Towns and Anthony Edwards, respectively. two important players that have already had a tremendous impact on this team.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good.
He does a great job of drawing contact and getting himself to the line, something he didn't do in the first period.
And a new group getting ready for the Timberwolves. Anderson's checked in for Reed. Prince comes in for McDaniels. Rivers has checked in for Anthony Edwards. And it's Noel in for Mike Conley. And he can't hit the second.
What I love about Kyle Kuzma is this guy understands there's more to the game than just scoring. That's a change from his rookie season. Now he wants to contribute defensively, and he gets on the glass, guys.
Tipped away. Stolen by Anderson. The drive by Rivers. Here's Prince. From outside, off the mark. The Wizards have gotten just 2 of 6 field goals to go in the second. Here's Kuzma. Missed inside. Pass to Beal. Fires from deep. The rebound by the Timberwolves. They come into this one having outplayed the Mavericks last time out.
You have to credit the game plan going in, especially at the offensive end, where they were just so relentless.
And that's not an easy environment to play in. To score at the rate they did on the road says a lot about their intensity and focus.
Here's Prince. Clock at 2. Anderson for 3. Avdija pulls it in. 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Kuzma outside. Back to right. Out to Beal. Gafford the screen. And Beal hits from deep. Beal's got 8.
Well, this is what you want, right? Bradley Beal coming off the screen with purpose.
Now here's Anderson. Oh, no good on the last second attempt there. And the first half now in the books. It's the Wizards leading by 8. Well, now we have some time to check in with Allie LaForce. Allie.
Brad, you limited their effectiveness early. What did you guys do defensively?
I think we just did a good job coming out with intensity. We did a good job frustrating them. You know, this is a team that's really good at moving the ball, and they got a lot of guys who can put it on the floor, go one-on-one. So, you know, we're just accepting the challenge, limiting them to one shot as much as possible, getting out and going.
Thanks, Brad. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Allie. After the break, we'll see you right back here to begin quarter number 3.
Howdy, folks. The moment you've been waiting for is here. Before we recap the first half, let's see what the standings look like in the East.
You know, right now, for the Wizards, they're dealing with some challenges, no doubt about it. They have talent, but maybe not as much as they thought they had. The effort's been spotty. It's been a learning year for this organization.
And we come back to the game at hand. In the first half, plenty to like for the Washington Wizards.
Nobody really expected them to be ahead at this point, but that's why you play the games.
It's been proven in the NBA, any team can beat you if you don't come ready to play.
Thanks, as always, for watching. Let's head back to Brian Anderson and crew for the start of the second half.
And we've got third quarter basketball here. 2 quarters in the books. Nice game. Great performance by Kyle Kuzma.
Yeah, I love how effortlessly he scored. The game just comes so easy for him.
Now let's see if he continues that trend the rest of the way. He certainly has the talent and the endurance to do just that.
Washington has gone 4 of 8 from 3, a nice percentage. Filling in the wings, Edwards and McDaniels. Rudy Gobert is out there with Kyle Anderson. And it's Conley in at the point. So that's the lineup for Minnesota. Now here's Beal. Porzingis sets a screen. Beal, the pass to Porzingis. That one's in there on the nice assist from Beal. Porzingis has gotten his first points in this one.
And Bradley Beal getting a huge contract this summer. Now, he committed to being with the Wizards for his prime. And there was some speculation he might leave, but he cemented his time in Washington for many years to come.
And the Timberwolves with possession here. After the basket by Washington. Outside Edwards. Lets it go from deep. It's rebounded by Morris.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
They get it back. Porzingis. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Boy, the aggressiveness in the paint from Porzingis. You know, putting the onus on the officials to make a call. You've got to make them decision makers.
First free throw is good.
Boy, you think about the surprises at the trade deadline back in 2022. The one that shocked me the most, the Mavericks sending Kristaps Porzingis to the Wizards. I was shocked.
Both free throws good from Porzingis. Doris, the big Porzingis trade really did catch people off guard.
It seemed when he was acquired by the Mavericks that Kristaps and Luka Doncic were going to be the backbone of the Mavericks for a long time. How quickly things change in the NBA.
Now here's Anderson. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. Beal against Edwards. That one drops for him. Edwards has got 9.
I'll tell you, what a night. He has been efficient. He's been strong. Unfortunately, they're still fighting an uphill battle.
Beal, the pass to Morris. Porzingis with a screen on Conley. Ooh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take 2 free throws now. Free throw good for Morris. Reeds checked in for the Timberwolves. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Third quarter here, over 1.5 minutes into it. Offensively, it's been a struggle for him.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
This one for 3. Rebound by the Wizards. Time now to hear from our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Thanks, guys. The NBA last season celebrated its 75th anniversary and announced the 75 greatest players in NBA history, gathering the living greats during the All-Star break. A lot of history, but Commissioner Silver said, we're a pretty young league when you think about it. Brian, I guess it's all relative.
Yeah, indeed. Thanks for that, Allie. Edwards can't hit. The Wizards have gone just 1 of 3 in the second half. Porzingis passes to Morris. Driving in. And it's in there. And the Wizards lead by 14. Now Conley. Taking a look at his numbers, averaging about 11 a game. Edwards against Beal. It's Edwards on the wing. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot 2. It's going to be on Bradley Beal.
Well, one thing you learn about Anthony Edwards, he does not lack for confidence. He wants to become the best to ever do it, and he believes he can.
Shooting 2.
Throw good, Edwards. And you see the ambition for greatness in Edwards. But, Grant, is he willing to do the work?
Well, B.A., think about this. He's a quick study, he listens to his coaches with curiosity, and he's driven to achieve the goals they set for him. Yeah, I think he can.
The Timberwolves making a switch here. Noel's checked in. And both free throws good for Edwards.
Anthony Edwards is one of the most explosive athletes in the league. He can burn you with his perimeter jump shooting. He's dangerous in transition. And look out, folks, the upside is there.
None, no good. Minnesota has gotten nothing to fall from outside in this third quarter. And out of bounds, the Wizards will take it. It's February. Let's see how things are shaping up in the East. You take a look at the Wizards. Right now, they're in 10th place, hoping to get themselves into the playoff picture.
You know, for Washington, they're really doing their best to rise through the rankings. Time will tell whether they can pull it off.
You know, it's got to be frustrating for them. You can't dwell on the past. You've got to think forward, work together, and play for one another.
Now here's Beal. Give him 8 points now. Can't hit it from 12 feet. Pass to Edwards. Shoots over Beal. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
This has not been a good period for this guy. Out of sync, not letting the game come to him. He's got to settle down and make shots.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Anthony Edwards. That's foul number two for him. And the Timberwolves making a change here. Rivers is checked in. Wright's checked in for Washington. Minnesota on D. A 12-point game. To the middle. Here's Gafford. And the dunk by Gafford.
And I'll tell you what, this is a guy who doesn't take a break at all on the boards.
Man, doing serious work. He likes being an anchor on the glass.
Well, but as defenders keep forgetting to box him out, he continues to just make them pay.
Here's Noel. After the basket by Washington. To the paint. Here's Reed. Uses the glass on the layup.
Well, easy money, right? I like the strategy. Go inside. Get a high percentage look.
Outside, none. Gafford the screen. And none is good for three. And the Wizards lead by 15.
Defensively, you can't afford to get stuck on the pick.
You know exactly what that takes. It takes energy, it takes activity, it takes intensity.
Now here's Anderson. Pass to Reed. And the layup falls. Reed's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Such confidence as a passer. He hits guys in stride and makes it look easy.
For Washington, they've gone 4 of 9 in the third quarter. Wright finds none. Now here's Gafford. Right side, none. And the dunk by Gafford.
Nice one-handed jam. Simple and effective, B.A.
Hey, with the lead, I'm surprised he didn't come up with something a little more creative. The Timberwolves have gone 3 of 7 here in this third quarter. Reed sets a screen. Anderson passes to Reed. Gets the three ball to go. Reed's got 7 points in the game. 32 seconds left in the third quarter. Outside, none. Comes up empty down low. Minnesota has gone 1 of 4 here in the third from range. McDaniels, that's good.
Well, the coaching staff loves seeing this kind of playmaking from Austin Rivers, the willingness to share the basketball.
None with it. From deep three-point range. And so it's the Washington Wizards, ending the quarter up 10. Their play has earned them a nice lead, one they'll look to build on as the game continues. Time for a quick break, then back to the action. All right, let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
You know, I'm kind of stoked this was a choice because I love this pass. A remarkable find. He put his court vision on full display.
Well, making the game easy for your teammates, all about putting them in a position to score. That's pretty.
Fourth quarter action is upon us. Thanks, as always, for joining us. Fourth quarter on the court for the Wizards. Morris and Beal are the backcourt pair. Daniel Gafford is out there with Denny Avdija. And it's Porzingis in at the center position, filling out the middle. Shot clock at 6. On the wing, Rivers. Hounded by Beal. Here's Gobert. And Gobert with the stuff.
Just great energy on the offensive glass. That's exactly how you cut into a lead.
Boy, a slam like that is sure to give him a spark. Washington has gone 5 of 12 from three-point range tonight. Morris passes to Porzingis. And here's Beal. There's the triple. Minnesota with a rebound. Gobert's got his 8th rebound here tonight.
Trying to close out. You got to know who's hot and who's not.
Well, defensively, if you allow him to get this close, you're playing with fire. He just happened to miss that one.
Pass to Morris. And here's Beal. They kick it out to Porzingis. Here's Avdija, guarded by Edwards. Here's Gafford. Got a piece of it.
Torian Prince has the kind of length and speed to close the gap and send it back. What a block.
Kyle Kuzma, he's checked in for Gafford. The Timberwolves have gotten just one shot to fall out of 3 attempts in the fourth. Pass to Gobert. And we've made our way through just over a minute and a half of this fourth quarter.
Well, after hitting one triple in the first half, it's been all radio silence since.
Beal outside. Porzingis sets a screen from 12 feet. No good. A bit long that time.
More often than not, he'll cash it in from that area. The defense might have done just enough to bother him.
It's Edwards on the wing. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for 2.
Let's remember, Anthony Edwards is 6'5 with a 6'9 wingspan. Those long arms, very difficult to deal with defensively. Draws the contact there.
Shooting 2.
Free throw good, Edwards. Both free throws good for Edwards.
They're doing some good work at the line this half.
For Washington, they've gone 0 for 3 in this fourth. Not good. Washington calls timeout.
That's a good timeout. They just can't hit anything.
Sometimes it just feels like misses become contagious. He wants to settle his guys down right now.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, Allie LaForce.
Hi, guys. I had a chance to find out what Wes Unseld Jr. was discussing with his players. He implored his team to fight until the end. He said, quote, "We might be up now, but we can't give the ball away. Don't let your guard down until the clock hits zero." Back to you.
And Allie, thank you for that. And so it's Washington with it. They have yet to score here in the fourth. Conley against Beal. Unloads from 13. And he gets the jumper to drop. And the Wizards lead by 8.
Well, Bradley Beal gets into the mid-range. Let's remember, this is a 3-level scorer. He will take what you give him.
Conley against Morris. Pass to Prince. It's Edwards on the wing. Clock at 6. The 3. The Timberwolves again can't hit. The Wizards have gone 1-4 since the fourth quarter began. Porzingis sets a screen. Launches a 3. He can't get that one to fall. Minnesota has gone 0-3 here in the fourth. Edwards against Morris. And that's good. Anthony Edwards for 3.
1 this half, 2 for the game. Stay active from beyond the arc.
A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Pass to Kuzma. That shot off the mark. And Minnesota the other way with it now. Slams it in.
Oh, the young gun, Anthony Edwards, with the big-time delivery.
Washington calls timeout. Some changes for Minnesota. Anderson comes in for Prince. And McDaniels is subbed in for Rivers. And the Wizards making a change here as well. Kispert's checked in. And the Wizards with possession here. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Morris sets a screen. Beal with it. And it's Gobert picking him up. Morris for 3. Nails it from 3.
What a pass by Bradley Beal. This guy is an elite scorer, but don't forget about his passing skills.
Edwards against Beal. Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair. It's going to be on Bradley Beal.
Well, that was clearly a foul.
And a chance for a moment to check out the scoring breakdown for the Wizards.
What a performance for Beyond the Arc in this game. They stuck to their guns, and it's paid off all
Shoot
game.
Two.
The other thing for this team today, they have a bunch of second-chance points. They're turning misses into makes.
gets the first, and that brings him within five. And he's unable to get the second one.
You know, he doesn't shrink the lead as much as he should have. That hurts a bit.
Here's Anderson. And the layup is good.
Love his attacking mindset. What a move at a huge point in this game.
That is not settling. That is going for a high percentage look at a critical time. Nicely done.
That was another look at our Mobile One drive of the game just a moment ago.
Yeah, BA, I mean, that's such a big play here in a close game like this one. Great concentration from him.
Porzingis with a screen on Edwards. Beal's shot is off.
He is too good a shooter, guys, to be left open like that. The defense just dodged a bullet there.
Conley passes to Edwards. Kicks it out to Anderson to tie it up. Offensive rebound. Count it. And it's now just a one-point Washington lead.
You see the kind of power that Anthony Edwards can play with. This guy, the board, the finish, yes, sir.
Edwards against Beal. That one off the back iron and out. Now the Timberwolves with it. They're on a 14-5 run. Edwards against Beal. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Anthony Edwards has all the skill and attributes to be one of the best in the league. But these are the moments, if you're going to be in that company, you've got to make foul shots.
Shooting two.
Ooh, he doesn't hit the first. That was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though. And he can't make the second free throw either. Missed them both. Expect them to take their time this trip down.
Yeah, B.A., the clock is theirs to burn.
Beal, the pass to Morris. Porzingis with a screen on Conley. Oh, gets the free to fall!
And talk about stepping up in a big way.
I'll tell you, it takes confidence to pull the trigger in that situation. You love guys who relish the moment.
Time called here. The Timberwolves decide to talk it over. They're down by four. 32 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter. Here's Edwards. It falls! And he's brought them within 2 points now.
Anthony Edwards has gotten his rhythm, and he's got a well-rounded offensive game. Look out.
And so they choose to intentionally foul. And now we've got an intentional foul. First free throw is good, and that makes it a 3-point lead.
A bona fide superstar in this league. Beal looking to help his team close strong. They need these points badly.
And so both free throws good, and it's a 4-point ball game.
Yeah, 2-possession game now after knocking both of those down.
And Minnesota calls time here. They're down by 4. 26 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Six seconds left in the fourth quarter here. Edwards against Beal. And Edwards slams it in.
Oh, give me a little sauce, Anthony Edwards. Rise high and finish over the defender.
And there's the intentional foul. No choice but to stop the clock here.
Yeah, and there's no question they have to foul. Now, I'm sure they would have preferred to avoid it.
Drops the first one, and that makes it a 3-point lead.
Now, this is exactly the guy you want there to close out the game. Pressure time at the foul line. Bradley Beal steps up.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 4-point ball game. 15 seconds left in the game. Pass to Gobert. Edwards with it. Fires the 3. It's hauled in by Beal. And now an intentional foul. They need the ball back as soon as possible.
And a smart choice right there. I mean, you can't allow them to just drain the clock.
So the first one drops, and that puts him up 5.
Well, Bradley Beal is the epitome of being a triple threat. He can drive it, pass it, shoot it. The complete package on the offensive end, that defines Bradley Beal.
So he gets them both. And it's a 6-point ball game.
Put a bow on this one. His composure at the line effectively ends it.
So we see the Wizards get the win here. They played the villain tonight, and they played it well.
Yes, they did. And you know, you have two choices. You can either succumb to the hostility in this arena, or you can feed off of it and use it as motivation. They did the latter.
And that about wraps it up. For Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, and Doris Burke, and the rest of our 2K team, this is Brian Anderson signing off. So long, everybody.